Thank you very much for the introduction. Hello, everybody. And today I will speak of joint work with Jacques Feijoz. And this so conformal symplectic dynamics. So what are they? So I will work on a symplectic manifold. Excuse me, I have some problem with my computer. 2 minutes. Okay. I don't know. So, assume I have a whole computer and all these things on the heat, it's too much. Okay, we work on a symplectic manifold and we look at dynamics that change the symplectic form up to a constant factor. And we assume that the dynamics is not symplectic. So the factor is not one, it's positive, but it's not one. So for example, it can be a diffeomorphism. And so you multiply the symplectic form by A that is not equal to one. Or you can consider a complete vector field, X, and you assume that the Lie derivative of omega with respect to X is alpha times omega, and alpha is non-zero. You can also consider time-dependent vector fields. In the case I wrote, autonomous vector field, the flow, the time t map of x, multiplies the conformal, excuse me, the symplectic form by the conformal factor exponential of t alpha. And what do they want to say? Yes, there is a very simple example, of course, where you have conformal dynamics. So you can consider a cotangent bundle. So, and the derivative of the Liouville form or any exact symplectic manifold. And you can consider the Liouville vector field. And this Liouville vector is a conformal symplectic vector field. And the dynamics is, so the flow is very simple. In the case of a cotangent bundle, so because what you have is a zero section. And the flow lines converge all to one fixed point that is on the zero section. So the zero section is, of course, Lagrangian. If alpha is negative, excuse me. Yes, with this conventional. Okay, I take the Liouville vector field, it's okay. So the zero first section is invariant, attractive, and Lagrangian. So it can happen that you have a Lagrangian submanifold that is invariant in this very simple case. Okay, let me go on simple remarks. So what you can remark also is that when you have such a simple conformal symplectic dynamic, M is not compact. Because of course, it has not a finite volume because the total volume is of course, equal to A, the volume of M. So you must have an infinite volume. And also when X is a conformal vector field, then because you have that the Lie derivative is equal to alpha omega, and this is just because omega is closed this derivative, then omega is exact. And so you have to work on an exact symplectic manifold to have a conformal symplectic vector field, like a cotangent bundle. Also, let me observe that it can happen that the dynamics is not as simple as I described before, because there is example that exists in Birkhoff. On the annulus, two-dimensional annulus, so you have a dissipative twist map with very strange attractor. And what I mean with that is that there are what is called sometimes indecomposable sets. So these are sets that separate the annulus in two parts. They are connected, but you cannot say that there is a union of two proper continua that is connected compact. So they are very complicated. Of course, there can be, it depends on which dynamics we look at, but there can be just curves, but there can be very complicated also. And so you cannot say that in every case you have an invariant Lagrangian submanifold, but on this talk I will focus on invariant Lagrangian submanifold, even if I know that other examples exist. So let me begin with some very simple remarks. So the first one is that if you have a closed surface that is invariant by a conformal symplectic dynamics, then it is isotropic. Why? Because assume it is not the case, then you have a domain in this invariant surface that has, I will say, positive area, and on which the total area of this domain is positive. And when I iterate the dynamics, positively or negatively, it depends if the conformal factor is greater than one or less than one. When I iterate the dynamics, the area of this domain that is always contained in this compact closed surface will explode. And it's impossible if you are on a closed surface. The total area is bounded. So such an invariant surface has to be isotropic. There is another case where you can say that an invariant submanifold by a conformal dynamics is isotropic, is when you have invariant torus. And you know that on this torus, the dynamics is C1 conjugate to a rigid rotation. There is a similar statement in the symplectic case that is due to Michel Herrmann, but that is harder to prove in the symplectic case. And in the conformal symplectic setting, this result was proved by Kaleja, Celletti, and de la Lave. And the proof is rather simple, in fact. So you pull backward your symplectic form on the torus, also the dynamics. And so you can consider that your symplectic form can be written as a matrix that has a norm, and you take a point where you have this norm. And because your dynamics is conformally symplectic, the norm will decrease. But it has to be preserved because it's the total area will be preserved. And so if it's not okay, I don't know how to say. I can say that. Excuse me. Okay, maybe I will come back to this later because some part of the argument is missing now. I will go back to this. And it's rather simple, but sorry. Okay. Now, I gave example, at least the first one, where the invariance, the manifold is isotropic. Also, the first example when your attractor is a zero section. And now, what I want to say is that there are examples where an invariant manifold by a symplectic vector field or a conformal symplectic diffeomorphism is not isotropic. And there are old examples of the Zabakdoff also, or Gygas, where you have an invariant manifold that is an hypersurface. And in the Zamakdoff example, I'm not sure it's obvious that it's smooth, but in Gygas example, it is. And so it cannot be isotropic in a symplectic manifold if you have at least four dimensional symplectic manifolds. An hypersurface is not isotropic. And with Jacques, we built a similar example, more with a point of view of dynamicist, to be sure to understand what is the dynamics on the restricted hypersurface. And so what we did is that we took an Anosov automorphism of the two-dimensional torus. We take the suspension, and then we added transversal direction. We obtain some four-dimensional manifold. And we can choose a symplectic form. And the manifolds that correspond to the suspension of the Anosov automorphism is invariant. Even it is a global attractor of the dynamics. And the dynamics is a conformal symplectic. And we can say more, so because we know what is exactly the dynamics, we can say that the restricted dynamics to the invariant manifold is, the manifold is Anosov. It has, of course, positive topological entropy. And in this case, we can prove that topological entropy is exactly the conformality weight. And it's not very hard to build this example, in fact. So we see that invariant manifolds are not necessarily isotropic. Okay. And that is why we try to find conditions that will imply that an invariant manifold is isotropic. And we remembered about Yomdin theory that gives a link between entropy and the way some manifolds are expanded, the volume of some manifold, so some S-dimensional volume of S-dimensional manifold is expanded by the dynamics. Because in the conformal setting, you have expansion or contraction. And so you can think to relate to entropy. Make the link with entropy. And so we obtain the following result. So assume that you have a conformal symplectic dynamics on a at least C3 conformal, excuse me, symplectic manifold. and assume that you have an invariant sub-manifold that is also C3. And so we have a condition that is not a condition in Yamdin theory. I will speak a little of Yamdin theory after. So we assume that the symplectic form restricted to the invariant manifold has constant rank. Of course, this rank has to be even. And this happened, for example, so it seems to be a restriction. But we can notice that this happens when the dynamic restricted to the invariant manifold, so F restricted to N, is minimal. This means that every orbit is dense. And for example, when your dynamics is C0 conjugate to a minimal rotation, this is the case. For example, when F restricted to N is C0 conjugate to minimal rotation. So observe that it is weaker than the hypothesis in the result of Kalja, Celletti, and de la Lavie I mentioned before, where the conjugation is C1. So you assume that the restricted symplectic form as constant rank, and you assume, then in this case, what you have is this inequality. So you have an inequality between entropy and the rank of the symplectic form times the logarithm of the conformal weight. And what you deduce is that when the entropy is small, for example, when the entropy is zero, then N is isotropic, because in this case, when the entropy is zero, then L has to be zero. And so the rank is zero. And so you can apply this result, for example, when you know that the restricted dynamics is C0 conjugate to a minimal rotation. And this hypothesis is weaker than C1 conjugate to a rotation. So this can be applied when F is C0 conjugate to a minimal rigid rotation. So I will try to compare this result with Yamdin result that can be applied also to obtain some statement. So Yamdin theory look at some dynamics that is so and look at the action of the dynamics on some manifolds that are not necessarily invariant, so pieces of the manifold, and look at the way the volume, the S-dimensional volume, if your sub-manifold is S-dimensional, increase when you dynamics act and you iterate your dynamics. And it furnished this kind of inequality. So Yomdin. Prove something like the entropy of F. So I will take the same setting. Plus, and there is something that is called the local entropy. So you have the topological entropy, but some terms larger than okay, something like that is more or less similar. And this term that is related to the spectral radius of DF restricted to N. So you see that the term is a little disturbing because even if you know that the topological entropy is zero, if the local entropies are large, you cannot conclude anything about L. When the dynamic is very smooth, so Yomdin knows that these local entropies are zero when the dynamics is smooth. So what we did is in fact that we improve in this particular case the result of Yomdin because we don't have this term of local entropy. So this kind of setting tell us that there are conditions to be sure that you have that some invariant some manifold are isotropic. So now at this part of the talk, I will assume that all the invariant some manifold I study are isotropic and even Lagrangian. And I will try to say something about their uniqueness. And if I have time, I will give some idea of the proof of this theorem. So even some statements are true in other manifold, symplectic manifold, I will assume that we work on a cotangent bundle that is under with the derivative of the Liouville form. I will denote by pi the projection on the basis. And I just recall what is the Liouville class, that I will call the Liouville class, of a Lagrangian submanifold that is homotopic to the zero section psi. So what you have is that I have isomorphism between the first cohomology class group of L and the same group of the basis that is induced by pi. And so what I define, so I think you all know this better than I. So if I have such a submanifold, so I know that lambda, so the Liouville form restricted to the submanifold is closed. But instead of looking at this on the submanifold, I will look this on the basis by using pi. And so I define what is the Liouville class of L, and of course, L is zero if and only if L is exact symplectic. Okay, and firstly, I will look at the invariant submanifold of the dynamics of this star Q. And what I will show is that there is only one Liouville class that's such an invariant manifold that is homotopic to the zero section can have. So it's not. So it's not very complicated. In fact, you look at the way your conformal dynamics acts on the Liouville classes. And in fact, so you have to assume something that your dynamics is homotopic to the identity. And because your dynamics is conformal symplectice, this form eta that if f star lambda minus a lambda, where a is the conformality ratio, is a closed one form. And what you have, that is not very hard to have, is that the Liouville class of the image of Lagrangian submanifold that is homotopic to the zero section is just so. This was the cohomology class of this closed form plus A times the Liouville class of the Lagrangian submanifold. So in fact, you have an homothesy. And if you look to invariant submanifold, then you have the Liouville class has to be a fixed point of an homothesy. And it's really an homothesy because I assume that, excuse me. So I assume that the dynamics is not symplectic and so A is not equal to one. So if L is invariant by such a dynamics, then its Liouville class has to be the only fixed point of this homothesy. So there is only one Liouville class that an invariant submanifold that is homotopic to the zero section and Lagrangian can have. There must be Lagrangian here. Okay. Okay, now if I think to the first example I gave on the Liouville vector field, I must mention that there are more complicated examples that are, for example, that are called damped Donnelly Hamiltonian vector fields that correspond to vector field where you add to your Liouville vector field an Hamiltonian vector field with some gross condition of the Hamiltonian. You ask that it is superlinear and convex. There are very classic examples. For example, you can take a Riemannian metric. And for this Hamiltonian vector field, you can prove that there is an attractor, a compact attractor. And so instead of looking of invariant submanifold, you can ask, are there in this attractor some manifold? You don't ask some Lagrangian submanifold. You don't ask that they are invariant, but you ask that they are in the attractor. That is the main part of the dynamics. And so the question can be, okay, I have, so maybe I have to explain. So what is conformal exact symplectic? So this means that this is exact, so A is a conformal ratio. And you assume that your dynamics, that is conformal exact symplectic. So why do I assume that? It's just to say that only UV form that is possible for an invariant manifold, is zero. In the exact symplectic, conformal exact symplectic case, this UV form is zero. If I want to give a statement for a conformal symplectic dynamics that it's not conformal exact symplectic, I will have to change a little the statement, and the conclusion won't be L is exact, but L has the Liouville class I described before. That is the only one possible for an invariant manifold. So, but now I assume that the dynamic is conformal exact symplectic and that it is homotopic or isotopic to identity among the conformal symplectic dynamics. And now I assume that my Lagrangian submanifold is isotopic to the zero section among the Lagrangian submanifold. So this means that it is Hamiltonianly isotopic to a Lagrangian graph, in fact. And I don't assume that is invariant, but that its orbit, so the union of the images of F by the dynamics, is relatively compact. This is the case, for example, when you assume that your dynamics, Lagrangian submanifold is in some compact attractor. So the assumption is weaker than in the previous statement, later statement, where I assume that I have an invariant manifold. I just assume that the orbit of my submanifold is compact. But in this case, the conclusion is the same. The Liouville class of my submanifold that maybe it's not invariant, but it has a compact orbit. The Liouville class is the only one I associated to the dynamics here is zero. And why is this true? So, what you know assumes that it's not. If not, so the Liouville class is not zero. And so when you iterate your dynamics, the Liouville class is multiplied by A. So so the Liouville class tends to infinity. It depends if k tends to plus or minus infinity. It depends on the place of A with respect to one. So the norm. And so the question now I address is if so the Liouville class of some manifold tend to infinity. Can I say that the union of the LN is not relatively compact? Okay, so I have my sequence of Liouville class that explode. Is there, can I choose a point on each submanifold that goes out every compact set? And of course, the answer is yes. So there is a first case where it is very obvious to answer. So the simpler case. Is when there is a representant of the Liouville class that doesn't vanish. So such that so we have a one form. Then in this case, what you have is that you have this equality, of course, and so what you have is that your two the manifold, the graph of AK of nu, they meet at some point, and the graph of AK of eta, excuse me, goes to infinity. And if you don't have the existence of such a one form, in fact, you have to be a little more careful and to use a selector of graph that you can build by using spectral invariant. And you will also obtain the same conclusion. It's just a little longer. So, and you have to curve on which the integral of the form is non-zero. And you will obtain the same conclusion, but with more sophisticated tools. Okay. So now I know that all the Lagrangian submanifold in which I am interested are in have the same Liouville class, and I will assume for simplicity that they are all exact Lagrangian. So maybe let me notice that, in fact, what we can prove is that you can, by changing the primitive of omega, in fact, you can prove that every conformal symplectic dynamics is exact. By changing the primitive of the symplectic form, in fact. So it's not very restrictive to ask exactness also. Okay. So now I want to prove a uniqueness of invariant submanifold, Lagrangian submanifold in certain class. So I assume that I have conformal symplectic dynamics, and now I will assume so there is a that is missing. So I will assume that it is conformally Hamiltonianly isotopic to identity. And this means that your vector field is dual to the sum of something times the Liouville vector field plus the differential of a Hamiltonian. And okay, now we look at only a manifold, submanifold, Lagrangian submanifold that are all H isotopic to the zero section. And on this set of Lagrangian submanifold, there is a metric, a distance, There are several distances, and you all know better than me, and you know a lot of such distance. And of course, as Vincent told me, other distance could work and to prove some results. But okay, I use the Viterbo gamma distance or C distance, dependent on the text. And what you can prove is by using a standard method is that, in fact, your dynamics with this hypothesis, if your conformal dynamics multiply the symplectic form by A of t, then it multiplies also the distance between two H isotopic to the zero section manifold by the same factor. Okay, and it's just a standard argument because your gamma distance, you can represent it by some area. And so this is multiplied by A of t because you have a conformal symplectic dynamics. Okay, so the gamma distance change when you use a conformal symplectic dynamic. And so, of course, straightforward corollary is that if you take such a dynamics, then there is at most one H isotopic to the zero section submanifold that is invariant by the dynamics. Because the distance between two invariant submanifolds will be always the same, so it cannot change. Okay. So it's a straightforward corollary. And now we can look at the kind of submanifold I looked before, the ones that have a compact orbit. So, for example, the ones that are in some attractor. Okay, and well, I changed the setting. You can observe I replace Q by Tn. And why I replace Q by Tn? Okay. Let me make some remark. So I assume that I have a conform exact symplectic that is conformally Hamiltonian isotopic to the identity of the cotangent bundle of my manifold. And I look at some manifold H that is H isotopic to the zero section, and that satisfies this hypothesis. So what can I say? I can say that if for some k, I have these two things that are different. For 1k, then the gamma distance between f n plus k of L and f n of L. Excuse me, it's not the same n. F L tends to infinity when L tends to, I don't know, plus or minus infinity, depending of what is the conformality ratio. Okay, and in some manifold, for example, Tn, there is this result. So that was the conjecture due to Viterbo and proved by Shilukin. That tells that if so this set, for example, No, excuse me, I will take if K is compact, for example, so is in some bundled, so what, how can I say that? In the QP with so if K is in this bundled in balls, then there exists a constant such that for all L, L primes that are Hamiltonianly isotopic to the zero section, the gamma distance between L and L prime is less than C. Okay. So if my two, in fact, the statement is the gamma distance between Z and L, but can use a triangular inequality. Okay. So if I have two isotopic to identity to zero section Hamiltonian Hilbert, the isotopic to the zero section Lagrangian submanifolds that are contained in this fixed compact set, then I know that there is a bond on their mutual distance, gamma distance. Okay. But what I said, if there are in my set FK of L two different Lagrangian submanifolds, then the relative distance of their image will go to infinity. Okay, so if I put this together, this implies that if the union of the FK of L is relatively compact, then for all k, fk of L is equal to L. Okay. And so fk of L is equal to L. It's invariant and it's unique because of the previous statement, later statement. There are this result of Shelukin is known on certain manifolds like Tn, and there are other manifolds. I don't think it's known on all the manifolds. There are recent results on other manifolds. And so this proves the uniqueness also for the manifold with compact orbit. I don't know if there are questions. So I have a little time to explain the some arguments of the proof of the theorem on entropy. So I will give an idea of the proof. If you agree. And so let me recall the statement. Maybe I can show you. Okay. The proof of this statement that relate isotropy, it was just after that, yes, that relate isotropy and entropy use part of the argument of Yomdi, but I will say the easiest part. I think the harder part of the argument that I won't explain is on local entropy that I mentioned. And well, that's it. Here we don't need that because we have this isotropic, this characteristic foliation, excuse me, in which I think all the local entropy is hidden. So I assume I have, I will write the statement. So I have an invariant submanifold, N, that is assumed to be situo, on which I have two forms, a closed two form that has constant rank. And I know that my dynamics multiplies the closed two form by a factor that is A. Then I have some inequality. I want to prove some inequality. Okay. So now I will come back to the end, and I will write this, what I want to prove. So I have some dynamics on some manifold that is situated. Omega is a closed two form with constant rank. And the form is multiplied by A. And the question is the entropy of air So, because I have this closed one form with constant rank, I have a characteristic foliation. Maybe it's empty, but so I have a foliation F. And I will use some chart. Which look like that, so it's a product. So adapted chart that that are built with the help of the foliation, with the help of the geometry of the foliation. And after that, I will use the to, in general, to compute the topological entropy. You use a partition of your manifold, and you look at the number of points that share some itinerary along the partition. And so I will use a partition that I won't be very precise of it with some small sets, Qj. And I will assume something. Okay. I will assume that you see the Qg are very small. So Qg are in some WA. They are each Qg is in some WI. And I will assume two things. The first one is that if I take a leaf of my foliation restricted to QJ. And QJ is in some WI. So it's mapped on some leaf, larger leaf of the foliation. Of the foliation restricted to WI, I will ask that this is injective. So this means that I will draw a picture. QJ cannot be something, I don't know how to draw it because, but for example, you cannot have a leaf, two leaf of QJ that are in the same leaf of WI. This is impossible. Here you have two leaf of QJ that are in WI. And the second hypothesis, so the second thing we managed to do is that now I assume that F of QJ is in some WK. And what we will ask is that the leaf of when I take the image, I also ask injectivity. So it's some geometric hypothesis. Okay. And now I think I have all the things I really need to prove what I want to prove. So now I take S, small piece of submanifold that is in some QJ, and that is that meets each leaf of the foliation restricted to QJ at most once. So something that is, and I will say that it is 2L dimensional, that is transverse to the characteristic foliation. Okay, and what I can say is that for all K, because of my hypothesis, if I look at the image of Ace and I, in the intersection with some piece of my partition, this meets also each leaf of the foliation restricted to QK at most once. Okay, so what is not possible is to have something that is complicated like on this picture. So you are transversal to the foliation. You take the image, of course, in the wool manifold, this can become very complicated. But when you look at what happens in one piece of your partition, it's rather simple in the case, it's, in the sense that your image meets the characteristic leaves only once, each characteristic only once. Okay. And now I just look at the volume now. So the volume of the image of my submanifold. That is AK of omega of X. And what I will say is that it is less than. Okay, I will look at all the possible itinerary. So the number of G1, GK, such that FK of S intersect. So this is just part of the partition. So I decompose my image FK of S into the partition of F that are given by the itinerary and sorry. And I will, I have to do the product with the volume, the 2L dimensional volume of QGK. And so I will put it's not QGS, it's so. What I want is omega L volume of some manifolds that are transverse to the characteristic foliation. So it's the volume of the symplectic reduction of the QG. So I will put something like that, symplectic. Reduction of QG. And there is a certain number of pieces of my partition. Okay. And what I have to mention is okay that the number, this number here, will give some information of the entropy. The entropy of F is larger than the lim sup of the 1 over k, this number I will call nk, logarithm of nk. And if I take the logarithm and I divide by k, this is bigger than, so what I obtain is log of a plus log of omega of s, that is something that is finite, minus some constant. Okay, and I will stop here, but what I want to say is that Urey argument is very simpler than Yomdin argument because because of this characteristic pollution. Okay, I will stop here.
Thank you very much, Marie-Claude, for this wonderful lecture. So are there any questions? So I have a question. So in this example at the very beginning, where you have this symplectic four-manifold with this hypersurface, which is invariant. So what is a symplectic four-manifold? Can you say that?
Which example, excuse me?
At the very beginning, you had this example for your conformal flow on a four-manifold with an invariant hypersurface.
In fact, we have to be a little careful. So we have, we take something on the two-dimensional torus. I won't give all the details because, with two directions that are, I will say, you have two, a contraction, I will say. Dilatation. I have a dilatation. I put something discrete, but and a contraction. Okay, and I take the suspension, and when I take the suspension, so I have another direction. This is vector field. You can think that you have no dilatation and no expansion, so the eigenvalue is one. For example, it's the simpler. So you have no exponent, it's zero. And what you do is that. So here you have an unstable direction. And stable one. And so what you do is that you put this, so you add another direction, you add another direction, I don't know how to call this, that is very contractive. So SS, and the contraction is such that, contraction is something like 1/λ2. It's just to convince that it can work. It's not the complete construction. But what I want to say is that, in fact, U and ESS are conjugate. Vectors I don't know what I did. Something that is done. Okay. For omega, so omega of SS is one. And when you take the image by the transformation, you obtain that. Omega of so lambda U and 1/λ2 S is 1/λ. Okay. And the other vectors that are conjugate are, of course, ES and the direction of the vector field X. And in this case, what you obtain is omega of lambda S X, that is also lambda, 1/λ. So it's possible, it's just to explain how the contraction and the dilatation direction are. But if you want to be more careful, you have to give exactly the one form, two one forms that to build a symplectic form. And yes, we can do that in a more careful way. But it's just, I want to say, we wanted that this direction are fit together, and it worked.
Thanks. Let me also remark, it's very nice that the that now symplectic methods enter in sort of a natural way in your proof. What I want to say is that I find it very nice now how symplectic, the new symplectic methods enter in the dynamical systems world.
In fact, we would like to do more.
Yeah.
To understand, for example, this attractor. I say that with some hypothesis, extra hypothesis, you can say you have an attractor. Of course, you have to assume that A is less than one, and you have to assume some gross condition about an Hamiltonian, for example. And we would like to know if the attractor is in some sense something that is it's not a manifold, but that shares some property of Lagrangian some manifold, to prove existence of an essential attractor in some sense. For example, in the Birkhoff example I mentioned, the twist map that are dissipative, Birkhoff succeeded to extract what is called now Birkhoff attractor, but it's not an attractor, in fact. It's something in the attractor, but that is unique. And we would like to find something that is unique in some sense, and that is essential. But in the case of Lagrangian sub-manifold, we succeeded to prove some unicity, but when the invariant set is more complicated, we don't know. But maybe symplectic method could help.
Thanks. Are there other questions?
In this entropy theorem, so do you really need that the rank is constant everywhere? So if the rank is constant, let's say, in an open subset of your manifold, can you prove the same?
No, because omega is when it is degenerate, we cannot control the size of our inequality of the constant m. In fact, I don't know how I can do in this case.
So even if in one point it is degenerate, so you already come into this. So you really need that it's constant rank without exception at any point.
Yes, in our statement, yes. But in Yomdit's statement, it's a difference. In Yomdit's statement, there is no hypothesis, in fact, on this degeneracy. In fact, in this case, in this sense, Yomdit result is stronger, gives stronger. Yes.
And another question which I have. So assume that you indeed have kind of a dissipative twist map, so you have some convexity in the problem. So can you prove graph property of this attractor?
No, there is counterexample. In fact, Patrice Le Calvez thesis, he gives an example of Birkhoff attractor that is a curve that is not a graph. And in the Tonelli Hamiltonian case, damped Tonelli Hamiltonian, we adapt this example with Jacques. And yes, Birkhoff theorem, so this kind of Birkhoff theorem that it is a graph is not true in dissipative case.
Are there any abstract kind of constraints on the geometry of the submanifolds, or it could be just arbitrary?
I think you can have a Birkhoff. Maybe I can choose something. if you know, but I think you know that better than me, if you know that the dynamics is recurrent, for example, then you can prove that it is a graph. I think it's not, it's exactly the same thing that the conservative case. But, and so the constraint, the important hypothesis, in fact, is that when it, what you can notice is when it, you have, when this, your environment manifold is not a graph, then there, be, there is something that is dissipative on the restricted dynamics to this manifold.
But, oh, I yes,
but I don't think that there are hypotheses on the basis. I don't know. One example are, of course, on tori, but I'm not sure it's essential. Don't think so.
Thank you very much.
Any other question? Okay, so let's thank Marie-Claude again for this.